The Division of Developmental Disabilities says you have a right to a fair hearing. Hello and welcome to this DDTV special report. I'm Ed Holen and I'm joined in the studio by our field correspondent, Emily Rogers. Emily, you've been tracking a story about DDD's administrative hearing process for some time.
That's right, Ed. I receive a lot of mail from people who disagree with decisions about eligibility and services, but they don't know how to appeal those decisions.
Emily, you went out into the field with the DDTV team to find out more about the fair hearing process. Let's take a look.
Good morning, Sharon.
It's in a room like this that anyone who follows the fair hearing process will tell their story to a judge. It's not a courtroom, and even though a judge is involved, it's not a trial. It's an administrative procedure. As a compliance and monitoring unit manager for DDD, Sue Podol's job is to clarify rules and policies so that everyone knows what to expect.
A client, former client, applicant has a right to an administrative hearing to dispute a decision by DDD that results in a denial, termination, or reduction of eligibility or services. So an example would be a family applies on their child's behalf to make their child an eligible client of DDD. They submit information, we review the information, and we make a determination that under our rules the child does not meet eligibility to be a DDD client. That family has a right to dispute that decision and go to request administrative fair hearing and bring forth additional information to prove that they should be eligible based on the rules.
Sue explained how you learn about DDD decisions through a planned action notice or other written notification.
If DDD has made a decision to deny eligibility, provider or services, or to terminate any of those, we are required to provide you written notice or planned action notice of that decision.
When you take a close look at this process, there are some very important details to watch for. The written notification you get in the mail explains your right to appeal any DDD decision by requesting an administrative hearing, commonly known as a fair hearing. You can request a hearing in writing or over the phone. A phone number and contact person are provided in the notice. You can request a fair hearing any time within 90 days of receiving notification. However, to continue receiving services during the appeal process, you must request a fair hearing much sooner, by the date indicated on your notice. You get a minimum of 10 days to make this request, so be sure to check for the date. I learned about one family who requested a fair hearing not once, but twice, and with very different results each time. Their story is a good example of what can happen during the fair hearing process.
My son Michael has autism, and as a result of his autism, he has a tendency to break windows. In the house, he's broken three. He broke one in the van. Well, at an earlier time, he had broken one in the van, and the state DDD paid to replace that broken window. So I figured I would submit a request and have them repair the other four windows. But what happened was it was denied by DDD. When I got my denial, the instructions were to submit a request of appeal to DDD in Olympia. So following the instructions, I submitted a letter. I waited 4 weeks, made some follow-up phone calls. A couple more weeks went by, a month went by, and the state DDD had rethought the process and the request, and then they rescinded the denial. So in essence, they went ahead and paid to have the four windows replaced.
A lot can happen before an actual hearing is set. Michael and his family are a good example of how a dispute can be resolved at any point in the appeal process. A dispute that is not resolved at this point would go something like this. After you submit your request, a fair hearing coordinator contacts you by phone to verify information and to find out if there is any new information that might change the decision. The fair hearing coordinator is typically a DDD case manager or supervisor. He or she wants to verify information and to find out if there is any new information that might change the decision. The fair hearing coordinator wants to determine if DDD made an error in their decision-making process. If they did, they want to correct the decision. If you are the person filing the appeal, now is the time to ask for copies of any documents that DDD will use at the hearing. Ask what witnesses will be asked to testify, and ask what they'll testify about. And be sure to find out what rules the division used to make its decision. This is how your appeal is decided, based on whether the rules were followed, not whether the rules are fair. Some regions schedule a pre-hearing conference. A pre-hearing conference includes all parties involved, plus an administrative law judge. It can take place in person or on the phone. The purpose of the pre-hearing conference is to agree to the issue in dispute, to share information, and to clarify representation. One key to successfully appealing a decision is to base your appeal on the way the division applied the rules.